What's going on, guys? Derek Manasco here, Mpact Real Estate, Keller Williams Realty, wishing you all an impactful day. I'm ready to cover step number two in our seven steps to buying a home. Step number two is obtaining pre-approval. We're going to talk about today why you should obtain pre-approval, what is the risk if you don't, and how do you find that trusted lending source? Well, let's go ahead and start with that. How do you find that good trusted lending source? By step number one in the whole process, hiring the right agent. The right agent should have access to local lenders who put your needs first, who can save you thousands of dollars. We even have access to some that might not be local, but they may be good options for you based off the property type you're trying to purchase. So for example, we have one who may give you a $1,000 credit back at close, waive all lending fees, and they also offer to pay for the appraisal out of pocket up front. And even if the transaction fails, they eat that cost on all purchases above $150,000 or more. So depending on the lender, there's a lot of money you guys could be saving when looking to purchase a home. So hire the right agent, and step number two takes care of itself. So let's go a little further now. We've talked about where to find that lending source. It could be local, it could be at a bank, it could be a credit union, it could be a smaller bank. It really is gonna depend on the type of property that you're looking for. That agent should be able to guide you to those sources and give you at least 2 to 3 good lending sources to help get you to the finish line and save you a ton of money. And so we'll get into another video talking about what all you need to get to the lender to get financing and obtain pre-approval. But let's keep this going. So we know where to find them. Now let's talk about the why behind it. The why is because the market is moving so fast. This year has been a historically low inventory year, meaning that in a normal market, there's 6 months of inventory if no houses were to be added to the market today. Right now, in our area, we're less than a month in some places, which means sellers have favorable conditions, with the exception of being the perfect storm that we're in 2020, right? Go figure. Buyers also have amazing buying power because interest rates are at historic lows as well. So it's a great time to purchase when you hire the right agent, you have a good plan with choosing your good local lender, and then also with that, what are the risks if you don't get a pre-approval letter but you want to go take a look at homes? You might miss out on that perfect dream home. I've had so many clients in the past who have wanted to not get a pre-approval letter, wanted to jump out of the gate and just go look at a home. And unfortunately, I have to tell them in a very, very polite way, guys, I'm so sorry this happened to you. I mean, you know, if we would have obtained a pre-approval letter at the beginning, you would have known your purchasing power. You would have known what that looks like, your payments, your budget, everything. And you could have gotten that home that you absolutely fell in love with. So guys, don't do yourself a disservice. Make sure that you hire that agent and get your pre-approval letter as step number two. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Like the video, subscribe, share this video with anybody you think this could be helpful with. And we hope you all have a wonderful and impactful day.